The first question I got was from Facebook, and this lady, her name is Jocelyn, and she's asking, is it possible or realistic to hope for long-lasting and well-made vegan saddles? I am recently vegan and I'm trying to lower the amount of products that I have with leather. Obviously, the performance and quality of my saddle is very important to me, but can this be done without leather? Thanks.
Okay, so yes, it can be done without leather. And Jocelyn, I understand what you're going through, and my children also decided to become vegan because of the way the animals are treated. And some people just want to reduce the amount of leather use, just like you, Jocelyn. Totally understand. So I want to, it's typical Jochen fashion, to answer this question in the sense of understand why it can go without leather. Okay, so a lot of pads made out of a material like cotton and synthetic or gel or rubber, like these pieces here. But the best part for the horse, what has been researched in Vienna by the University of Vienna, the professor's name was Christian Pam, was sheepskin and deer skin. So if my daughter or you says, I don't want animal products on that animal, why do that work so well? So it's a natural product, and this product here is there to protect with their skin, the horse's skin. So we have to think about horseback riding. It's not meant by nature that a human sits on the horse. So over all these years, people use products, is a gel, synthetic, sheepskin, or leather. We come to learn that certain products will protect the horse better, such as this sheepskin. Now let's go to leather, to the actual saddle. And when I'm talking about saddles, bareback pads, or what they call treeless saddles, you can see here is made out of synthetic, or like a neoprene here, like these pads. Okay. The entire saddle can be made out of that as well. And the question is, why if it's so much better for the manufacturer to work with material what is not so expensive, why do the majority of the people love leather versus synthetic? Because today, material like this material is this fake leather, we call it. Many shoes gets made out of that, especially in the theater world, when they have to make costumes for different plays. You really have to burn that material to see the difference if it's leather or fake leather. The material is so good, the imitation, that you barely can tell the difference. So the advantage is it's super durable, there's the answer. So you could have something out of non-leather, very durable. And the disadvantage, that particular material is super expensive, and it doesn't mold and take the form to the rider's seat and to the rider's legs and to the horse's back as leather does. So while we have very inexpensive neoprene or another material, what is sort of a blend between neoprene and velvet, and we have this fake leather, the majority of the consumer prefers the leather because of how it molds and feels doing riding. For people like my own children who will have less and less leather product, for durability, this definitely is a product when can be used. It's just a little bit more expensive because leather will dispose in ground. So when the leather saddle one day is gone and we don't want to use it anymore, or you throw it away, or you bury it, it will dissolve the leather. This material will never dissolve, and it costs a lot of money to produce. That's why it's more expensive to make and less used in the market because of the cost. Unless you go to neoprene, like with the Wintec saddles, then that's affordable. Leather, again, molds, but if it's an ethical thing, there are these options.